In this video, we'll demonstrate how to perform parameter tuning for a digital twin of a pump system with Simulink Design Optimization. A digital twin is a digital representation of a physical or virtual product, process, or system. In this demonstration, we have a physical pump system, and its digital twin model is created using Simscape, which is a physical modeling tool. The real system consists of different components such as the displacement pump, reservoir, motorized and solenoid valves, and a pressure sensor. And the digital twin contains blocks modeling the corresponding components of the actual pump system. In this system, we drive the motor using an RPM input, and the output we measure is the pressure. Using the measured data, we can tune the parameters of our digital twin such that it reflects the most up-to-date state of the real system that is in operation. Being able to monitor the real system's current state lets us perform various tasks using the digital twin. For example, we can perform what-if simulations to analyze the pump system under different operating conditions. And we can run fault detection algorithms to estimate potential faults in advance and take maintenance actions accordingly. For these algorithms to work accurately, the digital twin needs to be tuned to the real pump. So before we discuss how to set up a digital twin parameter tuning algorithm, let's take a closer look at our digital twin model. Here's the RPM input to the motor and the output pressure that we measure. Under the subsystem, we have the displacement pump block, which models the pump by using a set of parameters as seen here. Among these parameters, we're interested in tuning the displacement per revolution, the nominal angular velocity, and the nominal pressure gain, as these three parameters have the most significant impact on the output pressure. We want to know whether these parameters are up to date with the real pump or not. And the way to check that is to compare the simulated pressure to the measured data collected from the pump. If there's a good match between the two, that means the digital twin accurately represents the current condition of the real pump. Otherwise, we will need to tune the digital twin parameters. This picture shows how different things are connected through IoT. After we create the digital twin model and the parameter tuning algorithm, we deploy these to a production server. This algorithm runs Simulink Design Optimization in the background, and it communicates with an edge device that is directly connected with the pump. And finally, we have a dashboard that lets the front-end user to remotely connect to the production server and monitor and tune the digital twin. Currently, as seen from this plot, the digital twin simulation doesn't match well with the field measurement. And that's why we will now tune the current parameters of our digital twin by clicking this button. Once the algorithm is run and the parameters are updated, we get much better alignment between the two responses. What we're not seeing here is Simulink Design Optimization that is running in the background to tune the parameters. Let's learn how to use this tool for creating our tuning algorithm. We will start with these pump parameters, which currently result in a pressure response that significantly differs from the measured pressure. To tune the digital twin parameters to match the real pump, we will use Parameter Estimator app that is a part of Simulink Design Optimization. The app lets us estimate parameters by formulating and automatically solving an optimization problem to minimize the error between the simulated and measured responses. We'll start by specifying the parameters that we want to estimate. To do so, we will simply copy over these three pump parameters to our app. Once this is done, we're able to view the current parameter values. Based on our knowledge of the real system, we can determine a reasonable range for each of the pump parameters by specifying their minimum and maximum values. Having finite numbers here will help the optimization algorithm narrow down its search space and converge to a solution in shorter amount of time. After setting up the estimation parameters, next we create an experiment to specify the measurement data that we got from the real pump. The measured signals are stored as time series data in the RPM input and pressure output vectors, which we enter in the corresponding fields in the app. The associated input and outputs in the simulation are these two signals. The RPM input to the induction motor is imported into the model externally using this input port. It is the same exact signal as this one, whereas the output is the pressure measured by this sensor. By selecting this option, we can view simulated versus measured data. As expected, initially there isn't a good match between the two responses, so we will start parameter estimation by pressing this button. Once the estimation starts, we can monitor the estimation status from the progress report. With every iteration, the app runs multiple simulations and, using optimization, adjusts the parameters based on the difference between simulated and measured data while trying to meet the specified constraints. After several iterations, we see that our simulated response gets much closer to the measured response. Once the estimation is done, the model is updated with the tuned parameters. And now our digital twin accurately represents the current state of the real pump. In the next step, we can generate code from within this app by clicking here.
You can now use MATLAB and Simulink compilers to compile and deploy the code.
To do so, you'll need to create a setup and a run file. This example has instructions on how you can start with the generated MATLAB script and then split and modify it to create these two files. Please find the link to the example in the video description. The setup file sets up the parameter estimation objects for use in deployed mode. And the run file is a MATLAB function for parameter estimation that can be compiled with the MCC command and then run in deployed mode. If you want to operate multiple pumps, you will need to have a digital twin for each of the pumps. As we see in this dashboard here, we have a database of digital twins against sets of real systems. The model structures for these digital twins are identical. What's different between them is the recorded data and the parameters. Using this dashboard, we can tune multiple digital twins. We can even create an algorithm to enable either periodic or event-based parameter tuning for each of the digital twins. As we discussed previously, once the digital twin is available and up-to-date, you can use it to run hundreds of simulations under different operating conditions and assess future operating envelopes of your physical system. You can also run fault detection and classification algorithms and optimize operation of the physical system. This concludes the video.